is equal, del square is equal to curly square by curly x square plus curly square by curly y square plus curly square by curly z square. Now if I write x is x1, y is x2, and z is x3 in the Jetson notation, then I can write this del square is 1 over x minus x prime. This is equal to curly square by curly x1 square plus curly square by curly x2 square plus curly square by curly x3 square is all 1 over x minus x prime is equal to 0. Now what is x minus x prime? This is r. This is x minus x prime is r, the length. So this r you were defining like absolute x minus x prime. Now I hope you remember it will be equal to x1 minus x1 prime whole square plus x2 minus x2 prime whole square plus x3 minus x3 prime whole square and square root 1 over 2 like x minus x naught square, y minus y naught square, z minus z naught square, or x square plus y square plus z square square root is equal to r. So now, is this one is in the reciprocal? So if I will apply del square on it, if I will apply del square on it, then it will be x minus x prime absolute minus 1, right? So now apply this one, apply this one, all this on this, it will be x1 minus this 4 minus 1 over 2 as it will go up. So it will be del square, sorry, let me write this del square in form. This will be curly square by curly x1 square plus curly square by curly x2 square plus curly square by curly x3 square. And here you will have all this, which is x1 minus x1 prime square plus x2 minus x2 prime square plus x3 minus x3 prime square and minus 1 over 2. Now I will have to apply the derivative on it. So you know this one is symmetric with this one. Like the things that I will receive for curly square by curly x1 square from this term will be the same for this one as well, for this one as well, because they are symmetric. So I will just calculate one and then you will be able to see all the result. Okay, just apply it on it. Let's say I apply the very first derivative, which is curly by curly x1. Then it will be on all of this. Why not? Minus 1 over 2 is the power. So this will be one derivative. With respect to x1, I will find this. Don't forget that here x1 is actually x, x2 is y, x3 is z. Clear? So what it will be? The very first derivative which will operate will make this minus half, and then this x1 minus x1 prime whole square plus all the other terms, and then minus 1 over 2 minus 1, x to the power n, nx n minus 1. And then I will take curly by curly x1 of this, right, because it is inside this power. So what it will be? It will be 2x1 minus x1 prime 2 minus 1. And then of this, so with respect to x1, it will be 1. While x1 prime is the constant, so it will be 0. So the derivative is only of this. Here I am writing dot dot dot, means it is including all these terms here. Now what it will be? I am just simplifying one of the components, so there is some, you can say, remaining components as well. So this will be, first simplify this one, curly x1, then this 2 is cancelling with this 2, right? If I take this minus out here, then it will be x1 minus x1 prime square, what it will be? Minus 3 by 2.
Yes, sir.
So minus 3 by 2, if I will make it reciprocal, it will become plus 3 by 2. And then plus 3 by 2, if I write in terms of x minus x prime, absolute, because this all is x minus x prime absolute. So if I write like this, then it will become 3, because the 1 over 2 has come inside it.
Yes.
Got it?
Yes.
If it's not clear, then I can repeat. Okay. What it will be? This one. It is having remaining term. It will be minus 3 by 2. If I want to write it in terms of x minus x prime, then it will be x minus x prime absolute power 3, because 1 over 2 is already adjusted in absolute. You see, the absolute is 1 over 2. It is 3 by 2. So only 3 remains here, but it will be minus 3. And with it will come down, it will become q. And what about this one? X1 minus x prime. So this one will be x1 minus x1 prime. So this is only the very first derivative. There are, you can say, means now from analogy I can write that if I take minus outside, curly by curly x1, then plus curly by curly x2, now from analogy I will write x2 minus x2 prime divided by x minus x prime cube plus curly by curly x3, x3 minus x3 prime divided by x minus x prime cube. Clear? Means all the other terms will come like this. Now again I will solve the first term. So minus is here, and now the first term, when you will apply this on this, now it requires the quotient rule, right? So what the quotient rule is? X minus x prime, and this is absolute, and 3 will be squared, and it will become 6. First function, right? First function is x1 minus x1 prime, while derivative of the second function, and derivative of this one is 3, and x1 minus, sorry, not x1, but x minus x prime squared. Clear? Then minus x prime, and it will be 3 cube, because the second function into derivative of the first function. So what is the, okay, what is the first function? It is 1.
Because it is x1 minus x1 prime, so it is equal to 1. And there will be the other terms as well. Right? I have just applied the quotient rule, which is very simple. And now, I will have to simplify this one. Look here. X minus x prime squared. This is simplifying with this one. So it will become x4. Here the power will be 4. And x1 minus x1 prime divided by. So the very first term will simplify minus. Then x1 minus x1 prime. And this is divided by, oh, 3 will also come in here. 3 will also come in here. Divided by x minus x prime absolute power 4. Minus. This minus. This is x minus x prime cube and this is 6. So it will simplify minus 1 over minus x prime and this will become q. Clear?
Yes.
Now look here. 3 here from this one. Then 1 here this one means remaining terms their time counting. For each of them, you will do this. So, 3 here and then 3 of the rest. So, 3 here, then you do for the rest of the terms. 3 minus 3. Look here. This is x1 minus x1 prime. What will be the next term here? It will be 3. Let me write so that confusion is to be removed. 3 here, x2 minus x2 prime divided by x minus x prime 4 minus 1 over x minus x prime cube, right? Plus 3 here and x2, x3 minus x3 prime divided by x minus x prime 4 minus 1 over x minus x prime 4. Sorry, 3. And it will be delayed. Now look here. Take 3 common from here. So x1 minus x1 prime, x2, I think it is squared. Yes, it is squared, I think. No, it is not squared, okay, not squared. So look here. 3, then x1 minus x2, x2 minus x2, all these will add up and it will become 3 times x minus x prime. Similarly, all these will add up and it will become minus 3 over x minus x prime. So, you see here is q and here is 4. So, one this will come out. Sure, I do it if it's confusing you. It is easy. Look here. This one, x minus x1, one component, second component, third component. It is vector, right? Now the three components will give you one x minus x prime. So it means cancellation will be done with this one. One x minus x prime will cancel with x minus x4. So it will become 3 over x minus x prime cube. This will become minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So minus 3 over x minus x prime cube. And they will cancel.
And this will come out to be equal to 0. You proved it. That for x not equal to x prime, this is the solution of this equation. So the phi which was in the Poisson's equation, the phi that you used is actually the correct potential, which is satisfying the Laplace equation, right? Means to write it in this form is the right way. Because for x not equal to x prime, this thing, this side is equal to 0. Then this side should also become 0 for x not equal to x prime. When x is equal to x prime, what is this thing? This is huge. This is infinite. This is huge for x equal to x prime. What this side is becoming? When x is equal to x prime, one more 0, it is also becoming huge. So it means that this phi is actually the solution of the Laplace equation. Clear? So for x not equal to x prime, you are having this phi is the solution of that equation. Now, what if I use the spherical polar coordinates using spherical polar coordinates? You know what is del square there? What is del square in spherical polar coordinates? Del square phi is equal, the del square I can write 1 over r square curly by curly r, and r square curly phi by curly r. Clear? This is del square, the radial portion. So I have written 1 over r square curly by curly r square curly by curly r. This is the del square in spherical polar coordinates, while phi is this one. So I can write this thing is equal to 1 over r, okay, 1 over r curly square by curly r square and r times phi. If you apply this on this, this can be written like this. If you will apply, means you expand this one, like by product rule, you will again get this thing. So I can then write this thing is 1 over r and curly square by curly r square, and this is r. And for phi I can write, that this is kq by r, because x minus xi is r. So I can write kq by r. Now I know r is cancelling with r. So kq is constant and this thing is equal to 0. So in spherical polar coordinates as well, this thing is equal to 0 only when r is not equal to 0. What will be the situation when r will be equal to 0? And your equation will become undefined, and then you will have to use the Dirac delta function in order to remove that singularity. Clear?
So finally we have that
del square. Finally we have that del square phi of x is equal to integral and k rho of x prime del square 1 over x minus x prime absolute and dq x prime. Now you know that this was the value of phi was k rho 1 over x minus x prime. When I applied del square on it, so I wrote del square because it is not operating here but on this one. Rho is a constant here, so it's applying on this one. And del square 1 over 1 minus x square, you know that I can write in terms of delta function here. So I can write that this thing is equal to k rho of x prime minus 4 pi delta x minus x prime and dq x prime, and this thing is equal to when delta will give you value, when x will be equal to x prime. So for x prime you will have to write x. So this will come out to be equal to k rho of x and 4 pi. So it means k 4 pi rho. This is del square phi rho x. And this is the, you got the Poisson's equation back. Which shows that indeed this phi is the solution of the Poisson-Laplace equation.